Ben Bergeron and James Hogarth here with Again Faster. We're going to do something today that's going to make your lives incredibly enjoyable. What we're going to do is we're going to take a movement that hurts a lot of people and teach you how to do it much more efficiently and faster. Okay, it's the ring dip, but we're not just doing a ring dip, we're going to do the kipping ring dip. It causes a lot of problems. People feel like they don't have the strength to do this. It's not so much a strength issue as it is a coordination issue. So we're going to kind of give you guys some pointers and some little strategies on how to get that. So James, let's pop up. Let's just do a regular ring dip. Establish that first. What we're looking for in the ring dip, we all know, is shoulders to make contact with the ring, shoulders and biceps, and back up. Take a break for a second. Excellent. What we're looking for in the kipping ring dip is to use your lower body to assist you. It's very similar to the frog kip in a pull-up, if you've seen that. So what we're going to do is we're basically going to bring your knees up to your chest and bring your knees up to your chest violently and aggressively, almost like you're pounding your knees in your chest. It's going to create a weightlessness. And during that weightlessness, that's when you're going to quickly extend your arms and take advantage of that. Okay? So let's go up to the top. We're going to come down to the bottom. And as we come down to the bottom, now we're going to throw our knees up to our chest, and that's exactly it, James. Excellent. Back down again, and then throw your knees up, and excellent. Good, let's take a break. I know those are tiring. Okay? So what we're going to do is tiring for some, not for you. Okay? So what we're going to do is now we're going to tie these things together. And what we can do is when we tie them together, we can actually make it faster and more efficient and easier by doing a second step that's often overlooked. What we're going to do is as you descend into the bottom of that dip, you're going to then bring your knees back up again for a second knee pump. It's going to create a kind of like pumping action, which can look funny if you didn't have rings in your hand, but thank God you do. Okay, let's go to the top. Let's just practice do two regular ring dips. We just showed that pump. Excellent. And then back down again. Show it one more time. And back up. Now on the way down, I want you to tuck your knees up to your chest and then do it again. And then back down. And let's just do it. Come on down. Take a break. That's probably my fault as a coach. When you do it segmented like that, it's really hard. Yeah. What you need is a rhythm and coordination to it. So what I'm gonna let you do is kind of like take the reins off and let you go. Do a couple and just see if you can fall into the rhythm. It takes 3 or 4 reps to kind of fall into that rhythm, okay? Let's take a look. Come on down, pop. Excellent, and take a break. Much easier done than said, kind of the opposite normally goes. So what we're looking for is a knee pump to create weightlessness on the way up. That's when you take advantage of that and extend your arms quickly. On the way down, it's the exact opposite. We're gonna go down, but we're not gonna allow our 185 pounds to hit our shoulders. We're gonna go down and we're gonna, right the split second before our feet hit the ground, before our shoulders hit the bottom, we're gonna tuck our knees back up again to allow us to kind of take some of that weight off of us. Let's show it one more time.
Just a couple.
Just a couple reps. Allow enough to kind of fall into the rhythm. Knee pump, excellent. Really nice, James, excellent, cool. That's the kipping ring dip. Have at it.
I only weigh 177 pounds.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Wow.